the Super High Roller is the very definition of excellence. With an outstanding field, including the player ranked number one in the world.
I've stood the test of time. I feel like I've proven time and time again that whatever they throw at me, I can handle it.
A 23-year-old who believes he is the best in the world.
When I'm playing my best, I think I'm one of, if not the best poker player out there.
And a man who is literally out of this world.
That moment when you hit space the first time and then you see you're starting to float, and then the first look at planet Earth. Wow.
All have excelled in their chosen fields, but only one can succeed here on the grandest of stages.
Welcome to Atlantis and the 2014 PCA. I'm James Hartigan with Joe Stapleton, and we are beginning this poker festival with a big event for the ballers.
If you've got an extra $100,000 lying around, you can rent that bridge suite for a week, or you can put on your big boy pants and jump in the Super High Roller.
All the elite players you know and love have signed up, along with a few new faces.
Including a guy who claims to be the best poker player in the world. Guess we're about to find out.
As ever, we kick off another year on tour here in the Bahamas as the poker world reunites after the Christmas break for the PokerStars.com PCA.
Ryan Reese told the media he was the best in the world. Unfortunately, he's American, so he forgot the rest of the world includes the European Poker Tour. His entourage is a B-plus at best.
Morning, boys. It's a new year, new start.
Been here since Monday with the wife and kids, and they just flew home this morning, and now it's time for poker.
Hey, bro.
Antonio, hi, I'm Spider-Man. I'm your big fan. Can I take a picture with
sure.
you?
Sure. Thank you very much. Spider-Man. I'm more of a Superman kind of guy, but, you know, I'll take it.
He's German. This guy is German, Russian, and Jewish.
And this guy has a beautiful beard.
I'm just American.
You know, America, small country, tends to keep to themselves.
These Super High Rollers always attract the big-time pros and amateurs with big-time bankrolls.
Check out this clown. Literally, Guy used to be a clown.
Well, Guy Laliberté, the founder of Cirque du Soleil, is making his PCA Super High Roller debut. He's on the main feature table, along with 2013 World Series champ Ryan Reese, along with a host of high-stakes regulars, including Martin Finger, who won our most recent Super High Roller in London. This is the third level of the day. Blinds 800, 1600 with a 200 ante.
All right, Ryan Reese, what do you... Oh, that was anticlimactic. Check out that shirt, George Washington with shades, classic.
Action at the feature table has been folded around to Mike McDonald, who's got pocket jacks. He's in the cutoff.
45.
35.
45.
45.
And he raises.
A lot of folks claim jacks are hard to play. Watch how Mike McDonald does it.
Donnie Stern folds the button. Guy Laliberté in the small blind has 6-5 of clubs.
This would be a pretty loose call, but it's not a terrible hand to 3-bet with.
Guy elects to call Mike's raise.
Okay.
Martin Finger with Jack 9 in the big blind.
Marty McFinger getting some pretty good odds here.
He calls as well. So we go 3-way to the flop. Mike in position. Guy to act first. 8-5 deuce. Guy flops second pair and a couple of backdoor draws. Mike still ahead with jacks.
Middle pair could be big trouble for this Guy.
Action's been checked to McDonald.
Sweet board to continue for jacks. Nothing to be scared of, and you can get floated by a lot of worse hands. Eat.
Mike continues for 8,000.
Guy not likely to fold.
Call. Oh.
He calls the 8K. Martin Finger folds, so we're going heads up to the turn, which is a 6. Guy now with 2 pair and an 84% favorite.
Nice. I'm not sure about leading here, though. Maybe you don't want to give a free card, but Mike's probably only checking backhands that are drawing dead and super monsters.
Kentucky does lead for 13,800.
As it stands, he is in good shape to get paid here. His two pair is more disguised than the guy they pretend gets pulled out of the audience during O.
Gee, currently on the receiving end of the patented Mike McDonald stare down.
It's a nice lilac stare down today.
Mike calls the bet. Nearly 60K in the middle. And an eight on the river, which pairs the board, meaning Mike now has a better two pair.
Counter fizzle. At this point, Guy should probably just check and hope for free showdown.
He bets again, 26,000.
I don't think this bet is going to accomplish much.
Mike calls, and Guy shows the losing hand.
I bust.
Lucky river.
Guy played it a little weird, like that giant man baby from Mystere.
Everyone started this tournament with 250,000 chips. Guy's already down below 100K. As we head over to the secondary feature table, where Daniel Negreanu is just three bet Steve O'Dwyer.
This is a very small three bet, and Steve's getting a very good price. Don't think Daniel doesn't know what he's doing when he makes it this size.
Negreanu initially gibbonsed. He limped under the gun. O'Dwyer raised from the small blind. Daniel then re-raised, so his hand does look pretty strong. But O'Dwyer calls, and we go to the flop.
Steve, the slight underdog here.
It is an ace-high flop. That might slow Daniel down. Action's been checked to him, and he checks behind.
Even getting a great price before the flop, King 3 is usually a fold.
Five of clubs on the turn.
Steve's finally got a draw. Hooray!
Once again, it goes check, check. Seven on the river.
Now, even though it's been a little light on the action, Daniel's played this fine post-flop. Sometimes it's okay just to try to get the showdown, even with a big pair.
King high.
Better king high.
Two king highs.
I think Daniel maybe could have bet there, but there's actually a lot of value in checking and seeing just what the heck your opponent's turning up with there, which Daniel didn't actually do.
Yeah, I mean, what do you want me to do? I mean, like, check. Yeah.
Well, Daniel came second in the first ever PCA Super High Roller, an event won by Eugene Kachalov. Other former champions include last year's winner, Scott Seaver. Martin Finger took down the most recent Super High Roller event in London. He won £821,000 for his efforts. And Justin Bonomo won the Super High Roller at the UPT Grand Final in Monaco in Season 8. And Bonomo is our early chip leader, commanding lead over Scott Seaver. No surprises to see Ola Shemian, one of the early chip leaders. Mike McDonald also among the early pace setters. An action's been folded to Mike. Back at the feature table, ace 10 of clubs.
Would you say it's more lilac or lavender?
Definitely lavender. From under the gun plus one, he makes it 4,500. 9-5 of spades for Guy Laliberté.
So this is a fold. Unless you're a billionaire. Lucy Gooski.
Guy calls. He is in position. He's in the cutoff. The blinds are out. So heads up to the flop.
You think this guy's going to follow your rules of convention? He's been to outer space.
Well, that flop gives Mike top pair. It gives Guy two pair.
How is Mike going to run him down this time?
Mike continues for 8,000.
Seriously, this flop is more brutal for Mike than the pawn shop scene from Pulp Fiction. We could see it all go in here. And with this board texture, Guy should fast play it.
Raise.
He is raising. A big raise to 30,000.
Mike can't fold.
He's got Guy well covered.
I often find the Mike McDonald stare hilarious, but I don't think the purple shirt is helping.
I thought we agreed it was lavender.
Right.
Calling.
Calling.
Mike shoves and Guy calls. And Guy is a 3-1 favorite to double up through Mike.
That is a super annoying hand to see turned over.
Could always rebuy.
Got the best hand. Got the best hand.
I know, John.
Did you, Guy? Did you?
There are five cards in the deck that Guy has to fade. Mike can improve with any ace or any 10. And there's a 10 on the turn!
Oof.
Good card twice.
So sick.
Got him again.
Sorry.
Well, if a 9 come...
You still lose.
I'm Give me a rebuy. What did I say? Twice.
Guy is officially drawing dead. And that is the ultimate needle.
Well, now he can at least tell people he lost boat over boat.
Well, you want to draw another one in case I get a quad nine? All right, guys.
Good luck.
I don't know.
Better luck.
Unlimited re-entries in this event, so Guy's about to invest another 100K.
Here. So I have to go down there?
Yes, Guy, you have to walk. Sorry, we still have gravity down here on Earth. I bet there's no ad breaks in space either.
Before the break, we saw Guy Laliberté eliminated from the PokerStars.com PCA Super High Roller.
All right, guys.
But he's bought back in for another $100,000. Dropping 200K in a poker tournament is unthinkable for most of us, but it's a drop in the ocean for the man who reinvented the circus.
I own Cirque du Soleil. It's an entertainment company, and we have a lot of live show around the world. And when I was young, my dream was to hit the road and see the world. And the fastest way, basically, that permitted me to travel was to pick up the accordion, learn tunes, and being a busker. And then through this journey of being a busker, a street performer, I realized the pleasure of entertaining people. Then I started to organize theater troupe on steel festival, street performing festival, and then in 1984 I gave a shot at doing the first French-Canadian circus. And the rest is history. Going in space, yeah, that was the ultimate traveling moment. Trip by itself was divided in two. Obviously, all the training. I spent 5.5 months in Russian Star City. So you integrate a community of people, which basically are space cowboys. And then you have your personal moment in space where you look through the window and you realize that, you know, you're looking at Earth in relationship with the universe. The planet Earth is fragile, it's small, it's precious. You're seeing that layer of ozone just protecting the life on planet. So obviously, that was a pretty intense moment.
Cool story, Neil deGrasse Laliberté. $30 million sounds like a lot of money to spend where you can't even bring back a souvenir. Look, I brought you vast emptiness.
When a player re-enters, they come in as a new player. So Guy's taking a seat at our secondary feature table. Blinds are up, by the way, to 1,000, 2,000 with a 300 ante. At the main feature table, Ryan Reese is in the big blind, facing a raise from Bryn Kenny.
This is a fun hand to take a flop with, especially if you're the best in the world.
He calls with the suited Jack 9, Kenny ahead with King Queen. The flop, 9 high, top pair for Reese. He checks to the raiser.
Love how he's playing it so far. Bryn likely to continue with his air ball. He's got lots of backdoors.
Bryn continues for 7,100.
Top pair, decent kicker. Ryan should be going nowhere.
He calls.
Look at Ryan Reese. He loves the game and he loves Bryn Kenny.
The turn card is the 7 of diamonds, gives Kenny a flush draw. Ryan checks a second time.
He's got the perfect hand to check call to showdown.
Kenny, having picked up equity on the turn, fires again, 16,500.
That's one of those backdoors I was talking about, but this bet is ripe for a call.
Ryan going for chips.
38.
He's raising. 38,000.
Check raise, more like black raise. This raise is just gonna make Ryan lose more chips when he's already behind. Also, it opens him up being floated, which is exactly what I think is gonna happen here.
Bryn calls the raise. There's now more than 100,000 in the pot. We go to the river, which is the 4 of hearts. So the board bricks out for Bryn Kenny. Ryan Reese still ahead. And now he checks.
Now there's a good chance he's gonna face a big barrel from Bryn. I think Bryn's gonna bet here most of the time.
You just have to imagine, like, I want to bang, like, Bryn Kenny bluffs the river for 63,500.
And even though Bryn missed, he would very likely play kings plus, sets, and flushes all the same way. Ryan's put himself in a weird spot. That check raise on the turn has forced him to play a bigger pot with a marginal hand.
Is he thinking of folding the winning hand?
It's gotta be.
He calls! Great call!
He had that planned all along.
I saw him.
Even though he lost, I think Bryn played it really well. Hey, do you think Ryan sold action to this event? If so, do you think he calls it Reese's Pieces?
Well, Bryn Kenny has just entered the world of Twitter. One of his first tweets explained how he ordered too much sushi and didn't have enough cash to pay the bill.
Do we think this tweet is loaded at all, or is it legit? I think the secret is in the wink.
Loves a good wink, does our Bryn Kenny. Well, this time last year, Ryan Reese was finishing his hospitality degree. A few months later, he bested a field of over 6,500 to claim the WSOP main event bracelet.
Yeah, but what did he win since then?
It was only 2 months ago.
Whose side are you on anyway?
Guy Laliberté is in action against Phil Grusom. Both players with top pair. Guy has checked the flop.
Guy in bad shape again. Grusom's got him pipped.
Grusom bets 16,000.
Maybe he can get off relatively light. Or not.
That is a check raise to 41,000.
Now, I just want everyone to know, just because you think you have the best hand, you don't always have to bet a raise.
Phil calls.
Are you serious?
I am serious. And don't call me Shirley. Seven of hearts on the turn, and Guy continues the aggression, 52,000.
Like most billionaires do, Guy is going to continue throwing money at this problem. I don't think there are too many hands Phil will call flop with that Guy's still beating, though.
Phil calls. The river card is a jack. Two pair now for Grusom. And Guy is getting ready to bet again.
Oh, boy.
Out of a stack of 150,000, he bets 95K.
Poor Guy.
Doesn't look too good for me.
Guy's played this hand so strong, he's actually almost got Phil convinced. At this point, Guy probably thinks he wants a call. Phil thinks Guy's value betting, Guy thinks Guy is value betting, and they're both wrong.
The jack on the river, probably the deciding factor. Any other card in this value bluff probably works. Grusom calls, and wins a huge pot.
According to my maths, Guy could afford to reload over 2,500 times today.
That jack.
Which is looking like a distinct possibility. Phil Grusom bricked 4 50,000-pound bullets in the last Super High Roller, but between then and now, he won a 2 mil ball in St. Kitts, so that's pretty standard. Did she just kiss him?
Phil Grusom now third in chips. Two former Super High Roller champs sit at the top of the leaderboard, Justin Bonomo and Scott Seaver. And fifth right now is a guy who had a pretty good 2013, Ryan Reese. And here's a guy who had a great 2013. He ended the year number one in the GPI rankings.
And he nearly qualified for 100-meter hurdles.
He did not, however, win GPI Player of the Year. He was pipped at the post by Ola Shemian when he final-tabled EPT Prague.
Ola Shemian is trending.
Vanessa Selps became the most successful female poker player in history last year. She took her total career earnings to over $9 million. And Ryan Reese won the World Series of Poker main event for more than 8.5 million. We're gonna sweat with Ryan on this hand. There's been an under-the-gun race from Mike McDonald. Donnie Stern has called. Tobias Reinkemeyer has just arrived at the feature table. He's not gonna play. But Martin Finger looks interested from the cutoff.
If Martin re-raises here, we're only playing like 2% of our hands.
Finger just calls. King 10 suited for Reese.
Well, now we can play 98% of our hands. Okay, maybe not that many, but this one for show.
Ryan calls, Bryn Kenny folds the small blind, Jesse Chinney gives up the big blind, four way to the flop, which is king high.
Hey, me likey. See if Mike continues.
Into three opponents. He does. A continuation bet of 12,000. Donnie Stern folds. Martin Finger's out.
Pretty easy just call for us. top pair, okay kicker against an early raiser. We should just be in cheap showdown mode.
Ryan does call.
Maybe we pick up hearts on the turn?
No, it's the five of spades.
Ah.
See if Mike slows down. Doesn't look like it. He bets again, 30,000.
Mike's got a lot of double barrels in him. I still think we have to call.
Once again, Ryan calls. More than 113,000 in the middle. Queen of spades on the river. It pairs the board. Backdoor flush draw got there.
I don't think that's a terrible card for us, because I don't think Mike's ever double barreling with just a queen. Make that triple barreling, oi.
Mike empties the clip. He bets 80,000 on the river.
Okay, the long version is with Mike's line, his hand is almost always ace, king, aces, full houses, and then also absolute zero. We just have to figure out how often Mike would do this enough with hands like ace, jack, ace, 10, and jack, 10 without a flush draw. Those are the only real hands that missed. The short version, I think we've kept this pot small enough that we can call.
He does call, and Mike shows king, queen.
Awesome.
He flopped top two and he rivered a house.
Look, I don't have to say, I screwed up. Nobody feels worse about that than me. Nobody.
After winning the World Series of Poker main event, Ryan Reese, in his excitement, claimed he was the best poker player in the world. Clearly a man not lacking in confidence.
When I'm playing my best, I think I'm one of, if not the best poker player out there.
So how does he back up such a bold claim?
I'm very patient. I'm composed. When it comes to live poker and like sitting down next to somebody and looking at them and being able to tell if they have it or if they don't, I'm really good at reading people. So I think that helps me. I've always been very confident in myself. If I like set my mind to do something, I will put every ounce of energy in my body into doing that, whether it takes studying or just mentally preparing, physically preparing, whatever it may be. If I have a goal, I'm very focused to accomplishing it. It was the first time I ever played the main event. It was actually my first year playing poker professionally. For the final table, I was the youngest coming in and the least experienced of the nine. Well, I ran really well. It always helps to run good. I was picking up hands and they were holding. There wasn't one moment where it sunk in. It's like, wow, I'm the main event champion. It's hit me now, but it's still kind of hard to believe at times. When it's all said and done, I would like to be the winningest poker player ever. And I'd also like to be number one in the GPI by the end of 2016. That would be awesome.
Must be nice to have 4 beers worth of confidence every day of your life.
If he wants to be number one, winning this trophy would help him achieve that goal. Ryan in action again, under the gun plus two, jack eight of clubs. He raises to 4,500.
More Ryan Reese, yes.
King jack for Bryn Kenny. He calls in position. Pocket eights for Jesse Chinney on the button. He calls as well. Mike folds the small blind. Donny Stern folds the big blind. Three-way to the flop. 10-9 deuce. Reese is up and down. Kenny has a gut shot. There are two overcards out there to Chinny's eights. Ryan doesn't continue. He checks.
That is typically a slam dunk c-bet.
Instead, it's Bryn Kenny who bets, 11,500.
Bryn also semi-bluffing.
Chinny folds.
I don't think Ryan was going for a check raise. Certainly can't fold.
No raise, just a call. The turn card is the ace of clubs.
It's a scare card for everyone, scarier for Bryn.
Ryan checks a second time.
Totally understandable if Bryn gives up now. In fact, he probably should.
Bryn checks behind. The river card is a queen. Both players make a straight.
Everyone gets there, but only one guy really got there.
Bryn Kenny with the nut straight. Ryan Reese with the baby end, and he bets it, 21,000.
Some folks are gonna worry about being up against a flush here, but really, does this man look like he's afraid of anything other than living by your rules of convention, bro?
That watch is blinding me. Bryn Kenny raises to 77,000. And Ryan Reese is in a world of hurt.
He's in another really terrible spot here. He has one of the best hands he can have in his range, so I couldn't really blame him if he calls. Tough spot here. Tougher than woodpecker lips. Tougher than a $2 steak. Tougher than J-Lo's seat cushion. Tougher than Kim Kardashian's credit card. Tougher than... I'm out.
All right.
Ryan's calling.
Straight.
And losing.
Got lower straight.
Yeah. Lower straight. Cool story.
Listen.
Bryn Kenny up to 265,000. Ryan Reese down to 175,000. And not enjoying his first super high roller experience. If you want to play in an EPT event, go to PokerStars.com. There are qualifiers every day. Before the break, we saw Ryan Reese, the self-proclaimed best player in the world, lose a sizable pot to Bryn Kenny here at the PokerStars.com PCA Super High Roller. We asked Ryan and some of the other Super High Rollers what makes the perfect player.
The perfect poker player has,
well, I guess skill, money,
tremendous intelligence,
natural talent,
incredible confidence in her own game,
wisdom,
knowledge, and patience,
focus, experience,
alligator blood,
and discipline.
He'd be good.
I'm surprised Ryan Reese wasn't like, he should have blonde hair. His name should be Ryan.
Blinds are up to 1,200, 2,400 with a 300 ante. Paul Newey's just taken a seat at our feature table.
Huey, Dewey, and Newey.
Deuce four suited. That gets mucked. He calls. Bryn Kenny folds the small blind. Jesse Chinney in the big blind has 10-4 of clubs.
Come on, Jesse. We really want you to be part of the show. Duh. We're going to work in, I promise.
King 10 for Martin Finger. He folds. Deuces for Ryan Reese on the button. He calls. Donnie Stern folds the small blind. Jesse Chinney in the big blind with 10-4 of clubs.
Come on, Jesse, we really want you to be part of the show. Duh. We're gonna work in, I promise.
Heads up to the flop, and because Paul Newey folded a deuce, Donnie Stern is a 60% favorite. While he flops top pair in a straight draw, Reese with an underpair and a useless gut shot.
There's a very strong argument for a bet here. It's a great flop for Donnie's hand. Plenty he can get value from, and he's got a strong redraw.
He checks.
Well, Donnie knows what he's doing, so he must think there's more value in inducing bluffs, maybe?
Ryan bets 8,000.
Donnie's inducement has worked, and I know inducement's a word because when I wrote it, there was no red line under it. I checked it 3 times.
Donnie calls.
Inducement.
The turn card is a 3!
Well, that's kind of Ryan's gin card, so I'd expect things to get a little weird here.
Once again, he finds himself with the baby end of the straight against a player with the high end of the straight.
And things got weird by not getting weird. Check, check.
Ace on the river.
This is indeed a strange universe.
Stern checks again. Another example of inducement.
It's a trap.
17,500 from Reese.
Aw, oh, yeah, Donnie. Time for some sexy check raise action. Get in there, boy. Get all up in them chips.
Stern goes big, 62K, and Reese calls!
Whoops.
Yes, sir.
Ryan shows the deuce, shows he was the victim of yet another cooler. A stack of more than 300K now for Donnie Stern. Ryan Reese on 150K.
Listen.
Ryan's made more expensive second-best hands than that medical droid at the end of Empire.
He has a name, Joseph. 2-1-B.
Wow. Nerd alert.
Three-way action at the secondary feature table. Phil Grusin's bet the flop. Both Jason Mercier and Guy LaLiberté have called.
I like Phil's hand.
He's got top two. But there's a flush on the turn for Guy. We've only seen one of Jason's cards.
I like Guy's hand. And Guy's flush ain't so hot, but it's still gonna be the best hand a lot.
Now he's turned a flush, he comes out betting. 31,000.
I don't think Phil's ever folding this. He'll be behind sometimes, but he'll reevaluate on the river. Too easy to do this with a flush draw or a pair and a flush draw.
Grusin has called. Jason Mercier? Calls as well, with something.
Ace 10 or ace king with the king of spades?
9 on the river, full house for Grusin. Now, Guy may fear the double paired board.
Yeah, not such a great board to bet a flush now.
Action's been checked to him. And looks like Guy will bet again.
I think this bet will work more often as a bluff than it will for value.
46,000.
Hold in.
Grusin shoves. He's got both players covered. Jason Mercier folds.
8 high flush on a double paired board.
And Guy folds as well.
A good fold from a good Guy.
Ship the pot to Grusin. Now up over 650,000.
Aw, sad clown. It's funny because he's sad and he is a trained clown.
Well, that win takes Phil Grusin to the top of the leaderboard. Siva and Bonomo still up near the top. Well, we just saw the one-drop founder suffer a significant loss. Now the one-drop's first winner is in action. Antonio Esfandiari bets the flop.
Call.
Shaq shoves. Esfandiari calls. Aces against queens.
How's that two hands?
Dan Shaq getting unlucky here. He runs good at life.
Well, queen on the river!
I was just kidding.
Sometimes you just know it's coming.
Looks like Shaq has busted Esfandiari in that hand.
He may have also busted his headphones.
They're just checking the stacks.
I've never seen your box.
Yes, Shaq's got him covered. Yes, he is out.
And yes, he has a bit of a drinking problem.
Question is, will he reload? We'll wait to see if Antonio Esfandiari pays another $100,000 to re-enter this tournament.
Until then, him and his gorgeous girlfriend are just gonna have to go to the beach. I'm sorry.
Over to the secondary feature table, where 4 players have gone to the flop. It's Daniel Negreanu who bets, gets a fold from Phil Grusin. Timothy Adams with second pair.
It's the best hand. It's tough to fold second pair to a bet from Daniel. He plays a lot of cheese, even if he does refuse to eat it.
Adams calls. An underpair for Guy LaLiberté. He folds. 6 of hearts on the turn. Negreanu picks up a gut shot. Action goes check, check. The river is a 3. Daniel gets there somehow.
Gets there like the weird guy from the office who somehow found out about your house party.
The better part of 60,000 in the pot. Daniel bets a little more than half that. 32,000.
Daniel is lucky to have gotten there, but my guess is he had a plan to bet most rivers. It's not the greatest board for Tim's hand.
He folds.
Gets away from it, even though Daniel's hand was more disguised than the saint. Nice fold, Tim Zero Thee.
Who does stupid joke like that? I don't know, just me, I think. It's fun.
Daniel was recently declared player of the decade. So how's he feeling about the next 10 years?
The thing about poker is interesting when you talk about who's the best player in the world. A lot of it has to do with a little bit of luck and whatnot. Having said that, if you base it on results, I'd feel safe in saying that yes, I've certainly put the results together, not just this year, but over the last decade, to put me up there as one of the best. Based on the fact that I plan to be playing for another 10 plus years, I see no reason why I should slow down. I don't think there's anything so innovative that's gonna come out that's gonna, you know, blow me out of the water where I can no longer be successful. So I'm gonna say it's just gonna be me. So I'm definitely on that top 300 list.
He ranks himself in the top 300. Oh my God, the ego on that guy.
Blinds are now 1,500 and 3,000 with a 400 ante. At the main feature table, Ryan Reese is facing a raise from Tobias Reinkemeyer. King-queen suited for Ryan. And he calls. Round to Mike McDonald in the small blind. He passes. Paul Newey in the big blind. There's ace deuce of spades.
Oh, yeah. Nut flush draw. Get in it. Certainly getting the right price.
Newey calls as well. This is a three-way party. Reinkemeyer ahead for now with pocket tens. Wow, it's all spades. Nut flush for Newey, second nut flush for Reese, an overpair, and a flush draw of his own for Reinkemeyer.
I haven't seen a deck this cold since EPT Siberia.
Action checked around to Reese.
Ryan Reese is going to get a lot of hate if he goes broke here, but honestly, there is nothing this kid can do. Cabs are here.
He bets 11,000. Not much for Newey to worry about. Yes, there's a potential straight flush out there, but still. He just calls.
I forgot all about Tobias. Big pair, big spade, little chips. He could be in some real trouble here.
All in.
Reinkemeyer shoves. All in for 69,200.
There we go. Yeah,
good. And Ryan cannot fold.
That's 20s.
That's 22. Right?
Boy, this is just a silly cooler. I haven't seen a cooler this silly since Carrot Top's lunchbox.
It's 45, 45, 22 is 67, 68, 69, 69,200 total.
Michael.
Ryan Reese calls for most of his chips. Paul Newey's got him well covered.
Give him a second to disregard that he could be losing the 4-7 of spades. And... okay, maybe 3 seconds. No more than five, though.
He puts Reese all in.
Michael.
And Reese calls!
Not only is Reese going broke, but he's gonna get lambasted over social media. And fairly unjustly, too, I would say.
Good luck, guys.
Reese drawing dead. Reinkemeyer needing running cards. There's a slim chance of a split pot.
Let's do this. Okay. Come on. Seven of spades is okay. Give us a sweat.
I take both. Like, just...
The turn card is the Queen of Diamonds. It's over.
A good card.
Double elimination.
Ryan Reese, we hardly knew ye.
See you guys.
Paul Newey takes out two players and moves up over half a million chips on day one of the PCA Super High Roller. We lose Tobias Reinkemeyer and Ryan Reese.
Maybe not the best player in the world, but he was on the business end of more coolers than a fertility clinic.
Just before the break, Ryan Reese exited the PokerStars.com PCA Super High Roller.
Good luck, guys.
But the World Series of Poker main event winner wasn't too disconsolate, despite the poker gods not favoring him today.
The day started very good, and then caught a couple brutal hands, went down to about 150, grinded that out for a couple hours, and ended up busting. But I wish I could have done better, but I'm okay with it.
I don't think he quite deserves all the hate he is definitely gonna get.
Over to the secondary feature table.
All in.
Negreanu all in.
Huge draw.
And called.
I have a flush. Oh, you called? I have a flush.
JK.
And a straight. Good game. I'll tell you how much you owe me.
No, it's not gonna be a good game. I'm gonna sit here.
Oh, you still have chips left, that's right.
No, I'm running good, no worries.
Okay,
good.
One down. Oh, you have a heart in your hand too? Pair.
Not enough, Daniel.
Rebuy. Wait. What time is it?
Time to spend another 100 grand.
First time I win a hand against
that's
you,
true.
A big
that's
one.
I don't even
big
know
one.
How you beat me, you never beat
yeah.
me. Okay, because it's rebuy, that's why. Yeah. All right, well, what are you gonna do?
It's re-entry. Walk down there, turn left.
Momentum shift.
Two stairs up.
Okay.
He knows the way.
Sign the paper.
Well, I was going to double up one way or the other.
I would
7-8 of diamonds. Okay, where do I go get my... where's Courtney?
Courtney hauls around Daniel's sacks of money.
She'll come back tomorrow, Daniel.
Why?
She's 52 minutes left.
Yeah, maybe you're right.
You'll probably win it.
Yeah, just chill. Take 45 minutes off.
That's what That's what I was gonna do if you knocked me
busted.
Out,
so. 100 grand now, later. What's the diffs?
Well, Grusin may have busted Negreanu, but he's no longer a top 10 stack. Businessman Larry Greenberg is now on top, ahead of three former Super High Roller champs, Altigot, Bonomo, and Finger. There's another former winner on the leaderboard. Scott Seaver is sixth right now.
And it looks like it's gonna be 100 grand now. I mean, what was he gonna do? Not play poker for a half hour?
For $100,000, Daniel gets a fresh stack of 250,000 chips. Blinds are up again, and Vladimir Troinovsky's taken a seat at the feature table. He final tabled this event last year and finished second in the 25K high roller. With King Jack of Diamonds, he raises small to big. 10-5 of clubs for Bryn Kenny.
You can defend this small to big if you're a competent post-flop player, which Bryn is.
He does defend. He has the advantage of position on all future betting streets. 6-6 deuce.
Big whiffs.
Troinovsky set to continue. 10,000.
There's actually an argument for not continuing there. When you bet, it's hard to get a call from a worse hand that isn't going to bluff the borscht out of you in a later street, and better hands are never folding.
Kenny calls. To jack on the turn. Troinovsky now with top pair.
Oh, hi.
And he checks it.
Now, this line I like, slowing down now that he wants to get to showdown. Now he wants Bryn to try to bluff the borscht out of him.
Bryn obliges, betting 22,000.
Should be a pretty easy just call. I don't know if he's stressed, faking, or just really, really Russian.
Troinovsky calls. The river card is the ace of hearts.
This is actually a pretty safe river for Vlad, because Bryn is rarely going to get here with an ace. But I didn't mean he should bet.
23,000.
I think Vlad has played this hand a little face up as something not so hot. And Bryn knows he's got less of a chance of winning us at showdown than he does of being mistaken for a country music fan.
That is a raise to 105,000.
Bryn's made an excellent read on this situation. Now we'll just have to see if Vlad can make a better one.
Troinovsky, possibly worried about a six or backdoor hearts. He folds!
Bryn Kenny, my boy, well played, son.
Bryn Kenny made the final table of the first ever PCA Super High Roller in 2011. The same year his girlfriend, Anna Marquez, came close to making the final table of the main event. Well, let's head over to Daniel Negreanu's new table. He's been raised on the flop.
Okay, I'm in. I pay. 61, right?
It is.
60, there's the one. Okay, good luck, bro. Daniel, what's your name?
Daniel.
Oh, seriously? What are the odds of that?
Nah, he's just a massive online. You know what? I'm not going to ruin the surprise for him.
Three of spades on the turn. Daniel Coleman bets 55K.
How much does he want? 55. That's less than he bet before.
That's how I know.
So,
hello back there.
Sucker for a price.
He's an MP.
And good luck. One more. What's that?
Is there unlimited rebuy?
Yeah, it's unlimited for the first day, and then tomorrow you gotta play for keeps.
Ace on the river.
Some would argue that today's two bullets are also for keeps, but again, I don't want to spoil it for him.
I'm all in.
Coleman shoves!
Okay, I need a minute. Or two, maybe. I'm gonna clock myself. Really, huh?
I don't even want to know how light he's thinking about calling.
Hmm. What the hell are you doing, bro? Oh, God. No idea who you are. I don't know if you're good. You're probably good, because you have 100,000 to play this thing. You probably sold pieces, because you're...
Nice watch.
You got a nice watch, too. God, I don't know.
I'll put her two-hand, Vanessa. Come on.
Seriously, though.
This might be one of those special rebuy moments.
Wow, Daniel's putting on the cape. It's got a giant C on it for a call.
I don't know.
If in doubt?
Yeah, I call.
Whip it out.
That's good.
Yeah, that's it too. Good job.
What do you got there?
I think he's got me covered.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, he's got me crushed.
I'm not sure.
Really?
One,
got 100.
Got 125.
110.
Maybe 121.
You have 121.5, I think I have the same.
Yeah.
So yeah, okay.
Daniel's out again!
I'll come back tomorrow.
Oh my God.
Good luck tomorrow, Daniel.
Yeah, all right. Oops.
Daniel just spent $10,000 a minute on that second bullet. Oops is right.
His chips now belong to this online beast.
I bet he would have called faster if he just had your, like, four-sentence bio.
What do you mean?
If he knew you were a high-stakes online heads-up sit-and-go player that doesn't play much live.
He would have called faster?
I think so.
It started off okay. You know, I actually got my chips up a little bit and then lost a few all-in flips against Jason, and then one against Steve O'Dwyer, and then one against Phil Bort, and I lost the bullet. And then quickly went and got another one and, you know, put it over there at that other table. So there's only like 30 minutes left. I'm gonna take the rest of the night off and then come back in the morning fresh with the third bullet.
What's this?
That was actually, you're not nearly as strong as I thought you'd be.
Weird.
That was nothing. Actually, I must be strong because I could barely feel it.
I don't want to hurt you.
Oh, next time.
In a word, awkward.
Day one now drawing to a close, but over at the secondary feature table, Guy Laliberté is all in, blind.
You fold the set?
Guy also on his second bullet.
No way Noah folds this for a fewer than two big blind shove, but he may three bet it.
Blind, you might get a fold.
There's only like, I push blind actually. Are you kidding me, 85?
Noah Schwartz decides to re-raise, three betting to 18,000.
And Antonio knows Guy's cards before Guy does.
Not supposed to talk.
I was only off by one when I said ace.
Everyone else has folded. Noah tables the ace jack.
Guy?
Oh my God.
King?
Ooh.
I was just worried.
Seven.
Live cards though.
Very a lot.
There's one.
And there's a seven.
Oh, I was wrong.
Oh, and an ace.
Seven.
Better than the ace without the seven. He's still alive.
It's coming.
He needs a king or a seven. No help.
See around. Still have 17 minutes.
Ooh, bullet three for Guy.
Good luck.
Thank you. You too.
So it looks like Guy is going to buy back in tomorrow. These day ones really aren't about thinning the field at all. It's more like just juicing the prize pool. Guess we'll have to see how juicy on day two.
Day one is done, but registration's still open. Paging Messrs. Negreanu and Laliberté.
Well, for me, it's kind of a bad card. So pretty hard to get some so good hand today.
Next time, Guy Laliberté takes another shot with a third bullet as we play down to the final two tables.
All in.
Call.
All in.
Call.
I'm all in. I call.
Bryn Kenny looks to the future.
I'm very confident with my game. I think I can stand with the best players in the world.
And Vanessa Selbst won't let her short stack stop her.
I feel like I've been pretty consistently playing my A game, and I'm just excited to keep up the momentum and come into PCA with a bang.